Happy morning, children. Are you all fine and safe? Yes. Okay. So, have you all had your breakfast? Okay. So, now what is the lesson which we are seeing now? Yes, tell me what is the chapter name and chapter number. First, tell me what is the chapter number. Yes, very good. It's chapter 4. Okay, what's the name of the chapter, children? By seeing this, what comes to your mind? Yes, what is that? Heat. So, what is the chapter which we are seeing now? Heat. Yes, already we have seen 4 parts. They are P1, P2, P3 and P4. In this class, we will be seeing the transfer of heat. So, these are all the content. So, these 4 content we have already covered in the last class. Yes or no? Yes. So, introduction about heat. Okay, tell me what is the main source of heat? What is the main source of heat? Yes, very good. It is sunlight. Sunlight is the main source of heat and light. What is that? Heat and light. If heat is there, light is also produced. If light is there, heat is produced there. Okay. So, and then we had seen what is meant by heat, cold, and then examples of heat and cold, measuring temperature, types of thermometer, and then in this class we will be seeing about transfer of heat. What is that? Transfer of heat. And these remaining topics we will cover in the next class. Shall we go? Yes. So, before going into that, we will have a recap of what we had seen in the last session. Okay. So, what we are going to do now? Okay. You know that what had happened in the last class. Yes or no? So, you just try to tell me answers. I am going to ask you questions regarding the last class. You are now going to tell me answers. Are you all ready? Yes. Okay. Hot or it is called as heat. So, it is a form of energy. As I said you, heat is a form of energy. Yes. So, the electromagnetic waves, that is the UV rays, ultraviolet rays reaching us from the sun. It has both heat and light. The UV rays has both heat and light. And some of the examples of electromagnetic waves. Okay, tell me what is mean by electromagnetic waves. Yes, open your mouths. I can't hear louder. Yes, very good. Electromagnetic waves are nothing but they have both electric field and magnetic field. So, electromagnetic waves have both electric field and magnetic field. Yes or no? Have you seen that in microwave oven? It is a type of EM waves. That is electromagnetic waves and UV. So, they have both electric field and magnetic field in it. So, heat is a form of energy. What? Energy. So, it can be transferred from one object to the another object. Do you agree with this point or not? The heat travels from one object to the other. Yes or no? Yes. So, these are all some of the examples of hot bodies. They are boiling water and then heating of iron and iron box. So, these are all some of the examples of hot objects. And coming to the second one, what is meant by cold? So, these coldness is present where the heat is absent. So, coldness is present in the area where the heat is absent. So, ice cream, ice cubes and then an ice melting in water. So, these are all some of the examples of cold objects. Shall we go to the next one? Okay. So, how do we measure heat? So, what is the lesson we are seeing now? Heat. Yes or no? So, how do we measure heat? Yes. Heat is measured by an instrument called thermometer. What is that? Heat is measured by an instrument called thermometer. Thermo means heat. And then meter means to measure. So, this is a thermometer. Okay. So, what is the units used in the measurement of thermometer? Now, tell me, what is the unit used in measuring the length? For the length, what is the unit used? Yes, very good. It is meter and then kilometer. For the shorter distance we use meter, and then for the longer distance we use kilometers, and then for weight we use kilograms. For measuring time, what is the unit used? For measuring time, what is the unit used? Very good, it is seconds. So likewise, in measuring the temperature, what is the unit used? Very good, it is Celsius, Kelvin and then Fahrenheit. 3 degrees are there, but the most commonly used is degree Celsius. Okay, so what are the types of thermometer? Now tell me, what is the first type of thermometer? Louder. Very good. So clinical thermometer. So where is this clinical thermometer is used? Yes, it is used for measuring the body temperature. I'm coming to the second one. So digital thermometer. It is also used for the measurement of what? Measurement of body temperature. But here the digital readings are there. Digital readings are there. So one more advantage is that no need to touch the human body. So by keeping at a smaller distance, we are able to measure the temperature. So on the next thing is laboratory thermometer. Yes, it is used for the measurement of measuring temperatures in laboratories. And then next thing, maximum minimum thermometer. It is used for measuring the temperature of a day. It is used for measuring temperature of day. So when is the maximum temperature measured? Tell me, when is the maximum temperature of a day is measured? Very good, at afternoon. And the minimum temperature, morning and in the evening. Okay, so scale reading. What are all the scale readings? Celsius, Fahrenheit and then Kelvin. I said you right, these are all the 3 units used for the measurement. We have seen some conversions also. Are you able to remember it or not? Yes. So all are not same. If it is 0 Kelvin, if it is 0 Kelvin, in terms of Celsius, it is -273 degrees Celsius. If it is 0 Kelvin, Celsius, what is the reading? -273. And in Fahrenheit, it is -459.7. And if it is 0 degrees Celsius, if it is 0 degrees Celsius is equal to 32 degrees Fahrenheit. 0 degrees Celsius is equal to 32 degrees Fahrenheit. In case of Kelvin, it is 273 Kelvin. And so what is the normal human body temperature? Yeah, it is 37 degrees Celsius. But in Fahrenheit, 98.6. And in the case of Kelvin, 310. Okay. So these are all the scale readings which are used for the measurement of temperature. Shall we go to the next one? Yes. Unit conversions. So these are all some of the formulas which are used for converting. For converting Celsius to Fahrenheit, what is the formula? Celsius to Fahrenheit is equal to 1.8 degree. What is the Celsius? What is the temperature given there? Multiply with 1.8 and then add it by 32. And for converting Fahrenheit to Celsius, for converting Fahrenheit to Celsius, so given Fahrenheit temperature -32, so that answer divided by 1.8. And then for converting Celsius to Kelvin, +273, and then for converting Kelvin to Celsius, -273. Kelvin to Celsius, +273, and then Celsius to Kelvin. If you want to convert the given, if the given reading is in degree Celsius, you want to convert that into Kelvin. So just add 273 with that given value. And if you want to convert the Kelvin to Celsius, what is that? Kelvin to Celsius. So take the given Kelvin value and with that value minus 273. You will be getting the Celsius. Shall we go to the next one? Yes. How to read clinical thermometer? You have seen this or not? Yes. So it has a uniform narrow long glass tube inside it, which the readings are graduated, and mercury is filled. It also has a kink. What is the use of kink? Tell me. What is the use of kink? Yes. So it prevents the automatic fall of the level of mercury. It prevents the falling of mercury. Okay. So, but in the laboratory thermometer, kink is not provided. We need to take the readings while it is inside that sample itself, where we are taking the temperature. But here, we are measuring the temperature for human body. We need to keep the thermometer under the tongue. So, after that, we need to remove that from there. And then we need to take the readings. So, what are all the precautions? Tell me. So, washing the thermometer before and after use. Do not touch with any hot objects because it may break. So, while reading the level, it must be straight. And then, if it is 10 divisions. So, if it has 10 division between the reading, what is 1 division equal to? If it has 10 divisions, see here, it has 10 divisions, yes or no? See here, if it has 10 divisions, 1, 8, 9, 10. So, it has 10 division between here. So, this 1 degree is equal to, this 1 division is equal to how many degree? 1 division is equal to 0.1 degree Celsius. If it has 5 divisions, so 1 division is equal to 0.2 degree Celsius. Are you clear? Yes. We'll go to the next one. So, how to read the temperature of laboratory thermometer. So, but it does not has any kink. So, the readings are graduated from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. But, in clinical thermometer, the readings are from 32 to 47 degree Celsius. Yes or no? 35 to 42 degree Celsius. Okay? So, coming to the next, what is the today's topic? What is the today topic? Transfer of heat. What is it? Transfer of heat. So, what do you mean by heat transfer? What do you mean by first transfer? Yes, moving from one place to another. Have you heard transferred to some other place? Because they need to move from one place to another. That is what is called as transfer. So, whether the heat transfers from one object to the other object, whether it travels from one place to another, yes or no? Yes. So, if it is the case, see here. So, heat is a form of energy. So, it always moves from a warmer substance to a cooler substance. It always moves from a warmer, what do you mean by warmer? Hot body to the cold body. See here, it always moves from a warmer object to a cooler object. Warm is nothing but hot. So, heat always transfers from hot body to a cold body because there is absence of heat. Yes or no? So, see here. So, this red color indicates the hot object and this blue one indicates the cold object. So, now the heat is transferred from hot body to a cold body. This is called as transfer of heat. So, there are 3 types of heat transfer. How many types? 3 types. First one is conduction. Second one is convection. What is that? Convection. And then the third one is radiation. So, what are all the 3 types of heat transfer? What is the first one? Conduction. Yes. What is the second one? Convection. What is the third one? Radiation. So these three will three